Well, good morning, church. And this morning we are going to be finishing up talking about the armor of God. And that's going to be in verses 16 and 17 of Ephesians chapter 6, where it says, "In every situation, take up the shield of faith with which you can extinguish all the flaming arrows of the evil one. Take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God." So it's just talking about three different things, a shield, a helmet, and a sword. And what's important to remember about all of the different aspects of the armor of God is how much they tie in to God's word, which he actually says is the sword. Now, when he says that, he's not meaning you take a Bible and you just start swinging it around at people, hitting them in the head, hoping something sticks. What he's talking about is understanding God's word, being in it and knowing it well enough to use it correctly. Unfortunately, there's a lot of people that try to twist what different verses actually mean. And one example we see of that actually happens in the Bible is Satan himself. When he's tempting Jesus in the wilderness, he actually twists what Scripture says to try and get Jesus to sin. And obviously it didn't work. But unfortunately, that still happens in our lives. Sometimes it's we read the Bible and we start twisting it in our head just because we want it to say a certain thing, even though it really doesn't if you look at the context it's in. So what I challenge you to do is when we're reading God's word, make sure you're understanding what you're reading. Don't just read it, take it at face value. Sometimes we need to know the context a lot better to truly understand what it's talking about. And I think that honestly will help us strengthen that shield of faith that he's talking about. Our faith is strengthened when we better understand who God really is and what the Bible actually says about him. And so it's important when facing off that temptation. Obviously, all of these different items in the armor of God, they all point back to God's word and understanding God's word, what it says about our salvation, what it says about how our faith can be strengthened. Everything ties back in to being in God's word and knowing it well. And so I hope that we're always trying to learn more from God's word, that we're always trying to cling closer to him when we're facing those temptations in our lives.